Hi everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And this is our second tutorial on Tally.ERP 9. And in this tutorial I will show you that how you can create a new company to start working with Tally. Whereas according to my experience, I can tell you that if you live in India, then you can manage your accounting in Tally. Not only accounting, but you can also manage stocking inside Tally.ERP 9. For stocking, I mean inventory, and you need to take care of all the stock you have. That means all the items available inside your organization. I think you can do that inside Tally.ERP 9. So I will start with creating a new company. So let's begin. So here I open Tally.ERP 9. And that is the first screen that you will see if you are using an education mode license. As I have told you in my previous lecture that how you can download and install Tally.ERP 9 on your system. So that is the second tutorial. Here I will tell you about creating a new company to start working inside Tally. So here I will go with work in educational mode, and that is the first screen that you will see and you will start working inside the Tally for the first time. So I will recommend you to use your keyboard, and here you can use the arrow keys to move up and down, and to select an option you just need to hit the enter key. And here, as I need to create a new company, so I will move here and will hit the enter key. Or you can also press the highlighted color. As you can see here that for select company the highlighted color is S, and for login as remote user L, and here for create company is C, and therefore backup for B and restore for R. So if I am here and if I press the C key, then it will automatically jump to this link, create company, and automatically hit the enter key. So that will be much easier if you use the shortcuts. So I press C, and here I am inside the create company dialog box. So here on the top you can see the folder path, as I have discussed in my previous video that you have to take care of this folder. That is very important, because all your data that you are going to feed in your company, that is going to save in this folder. So you have to take care about that. And you can watch my previous video about how to configure this folder path. So here in the name, I will go with Kohli Computer Institute, hit the enter key to move next. And if you want to move back, then I will suggest you to use the backspace keys. You can also use the up arrow key, but I will recommend you, if you have pressed the enter key by mistake and you immediately want to move to backward, then use backspace. And the next thing is mailing name. Here is a difference between the name and mailing name. If I go there and type here KCI instead of Kohli Computer, here I type the full name. So it is up to me that what name I want to see or print inside Tally. I can go with this name, or I can go with this name, or I can also use both of the names at many places. So that is why you have two options here. So the next thing is address. So here I go with the address. So here is another interesting thing in Tally.ERP 9, that you don't need to use caps lock or shift key to write in title case. So the title case means the first letter of each word will be capital. So here I don't need to hold down the shift key, each word's first letter in capital. I can just go typing and it will automatically capitalize the first letter. So here I need to specify the country. So that is very important here, because a lot of settings and a lot of accounting taxes depends on the country. So what country you choose here will also change many default settings inside the Tally. So here I will go with India, and here is state, so I will remove the state from here because I have a separate option here, Punjab. And you can see that as soon as I start typing the state name, here you have on the right side list of states, and that is the most important thing in Tally, that when you start typing, when these kind of list open, just as I have typed P, and here you can see that the list has shortened and it is only showing those state names which has the letter P. So when I type U, you can see that list is getting shorter, P, U, N, and there you have Punjab. So you don't need to type the full name here, you can just press enter here. So that is very important because you will see that kind of menus very commonly in Tally ERP 9. So here I go with pin code, mobile number 4051549, and I would also like to type country and state code, that is the full phone number, and here is my mobile number. I don't have fax, I have an email address, and I will go with this one. I don't have a website, but I have a YouTube channel, so I will go with this address. So here you have the most important thing, the financial year to begin with. So that is very important because you can't correct it later on. I mean, if you by mistake type here 142017, that is the way we write dates in India, because in India we write the day first, then the month, and then the year, whereas in America they use month first, then day, and then year. So you have to take care of that. It depends on the country that you will choose from this list, so you have to take care of that. So it is very important that you type the financial year from which you want to begin the books in Tally ERP 9. So you can't change it later, means you can change the year here, financial year here later on as well, but you also have to change the date of each voucher that you have entered by mistake in any wrong year. That means if you have entered 5000 voucher, then you have to change the date of each voucher manually, so it will be a very longer process. So that is why I am telling you that you have to take care of the financial year very seriously. So the next thing is books beginning from, and here you can decide that from what date you want to start Tally to let you enter the vouchers. So here if I choose 172017, so that means Tally will not let you enter any voucher from 1st April to 30th June. So I will show you that how it works. And here you can use a Tally vault password if you want to. I will not apply any password right now, so I will leave both of these security features blank here. And here you can see the currency information, and that also depends on the country that you will choose above. And here you can see your currency symbol, that is rupee, and here you can see the formal name that we type in English, that is INR, Indian rupees, that means, and we don't suffix or symbol, that means that symbol is prefixed to our currency. That means we type rupees 100, not 100 rupees. So that is why it is set by default to no. And here then you have add space between amount and symbol, and that is set to yes by default. That means if you type 100 rupees, then in Tally it will show like that, rupees space 100. You will first have the symbol, rupee symbol, then a little space there, and then the amount. So it is set to by default, And if you don't like, then you can set it to no by typing N and hit the enter key. Show amount in millions, and that is set to no by default. And let me show you the meaning of this feature. And that is, in million you write like that, and in lakh and crores you type like that way. So these are two different currency formats. The top one is American and the following is Indian. And in America, if you want to write 1 million, then you will go like that. 1 comma here and 1 zero here. And in India, you will type it like that. So that is the difference of using this feature, show amount in millions. So it is up to you that which feature you want to use. And of course, if you are in India, then you will set it to no. And number of decimal places is 2, and that means after amount, if you want to write paisa, then after decimal you only type 2 decimal places in India, that is 1 rupees 75 paisa, and we have 99, the maximum amount of paisa. If you use 100, then it will convert to 1 rupees. So the maximum decimal places value will be 2, so you can write up to 99. So the next thing is word representing amount after decimal, and that is called paisa, and that is 1 rupee 99 paisa. So number of decimal places for amount in words, and that will also be 2 if you want to write the amount in English words, like 100 rupees or rupees 100. And then hit the enter key, and that was the last option. And now it is asking if you want to accept all this data. And whenever you see this dialog boxes with the option yes or no, for yes you can either hit the enter key, or you can also press the Y key, or for no you can press the N key, or you can also press the escape key. So it is up to you. And another thing I would like to tell you here, that now I press the N key to hit the no option, so I am on the top again. Here you can see that I am inside the directory option. So I have to press enter key several times to get back the same option, just like that. So if anytime if you have pressed the escape or N key by mistake, and you again want to move to the final, the accept dialog box, yes or no, then you can press the Control A shortcut, and that will accept all your command at once. So that is the final screen that you will see Gateway of Tally after the creation of the company. So we will not dig into it more right now in this tutorial. Let me tell you another thing about the creation of the company. And now I am going to quit Tally.INI here. Press the hit the enter key and press yes, or again you can hit the enter key for yes. Now again I am going to open Tally ERP 9, and the next time when you will choose work in education mode, then you can see that you are now directly onto the Gateway of Tally menu. Whereas when we didn't have any company, then you have seen this menu. So why the difference here? So that is a very important thing here to learn, that how you can change the default company. So when the next time you start Tally and go with work in education mode, and then you can see that it has automatically selected the first company you created in the previous step, and that is KCI. You can see the detail in the left side pane here. And now if you want to move back to that main menu, company selection and creation menu, then you can see a few options in the right side menu. And here you can see F1 for select company and F1 with underline for shut company. The single underline is used with Alt key. So if you want to shut this company, then you have to hold the Alt key and then press F1. and now you are back on the company info menu. And here again you can create another company if you want to, or you can hit the enter key on the select company option, and here you will see a list of all the companies and you can choose with which you want to work. So the last thing that I would like to share here is that if you go to this PC and open C drive and go to program files, Tally ERP9, and again that configuration setting file, then here you can see that the default companies option is set to yes. So, and here is the company number, and that number you can see here. Let me show you. So as soon as I will press enter on work in education mode, it will select the default company KCI. And if I press Alt F1 to shut this company and again hit select company, then you can see the company number right here. And the same number is available here. That means whatever company you want to make your default company, you can type its number here. And if you don't want to make any company a default company, then just set this option to no. And then save this file by clicking on file, save, and then close this. Now the next time when you will run Tally ERP9, just remember that to come out from Tally ERP9, whenever you want to quit Tally, just start pressing escape key and until you see this final quit yes or no dialog box. So the next time, let me show you again. So the next time when you will start Tally ERP9 and hit on work in education mode, then you will be presented with company info dialog box instead of selecting the default company. So that is the difference, and that was important to tell you, because if you are continuously going to use this software, then you have to know these basic things about your data, especially about your data. So I hope you will